Bienvenue à vous sur le stand de Diamond Aircraft. Diamond fête aujourd'hui les 20 ans du DA-42. Mais il n'y a pas que des bimoteurs sur le stand et on a aussi des monomoteurs intéressants, dont un qui est derrière nous, un expérimental qui a volé en 2023. Thank you for your warm welcome on your booth.
Thank
and I've just told our viewers that you are celebrating this year the 20 years of the DA-42.
But yes.
We have got here on your booth multiple multi-engine propellers, but mm-hmm. we've got some single engine that are very interesting and
the new one. Technology, yeah.
So you're in charge of the development of the EDR40.
Yeah.
The EDR40 is the adaptation in some sort of the DR40 four-seater mm-hmm. and with reciprocating engine. With an electric power.
Yeah, that's correct. So the EDA-40 is based on a really well-known aircraft principle, the DA-40NG, which a lot of our customers use for pilot training. In the past, Diamond has experimented quite a lot with electric architectures. We had several research and development programs in the past, but now we're really focusing on trying to be one of the first to bring a certified full electric aircraft on the market for pilot training.
The plane we have on the backside is a real plane,
yep.
is the real test plane. When did you perform the first flight?
Yeah, so we are right in the middle of our testing campaign. So we flew this aircraft for the first time in the summer last year, so July 2023. And since then we've accumulated several hours of flight testing and really gaining experience mm-hmm. in electric aviation.
The introduction of the electric engine and the batteries makes the original DR40 from four-seaters to a two-seater, that's right?
Yes, that's correct. So moving from a combustion engine aircraft to an electric aircraft had a couple of challenges. One big one was that mm-hmm. the weight of the batteries. To allow for more than an hour of flight time, we needed to equip as much batteries as possible. So we needed to reduce the aircraft payload, reducing it from four seats to initially two seats. But as soon as the battery technology will be upgraded mm-hmm. in the future, say 2 to 4 years out, we would market it also as a three-seater.
Speaking about the techniques, can we speak about the engine you choose and the propeller and so on, the batteries?
Yeah, so this is all novel technology which we're using. So we're working together with two main partners. We're working together with a US partner, EP Systems, for the development of the battery system. And we're working with a well-known French company, Safran, that's producing the electric motor mm-hmm. for us.
What kind of battery, what kind of power?
So it's the power ratings are similar to the combustion engine aircraft, the DA-40NG. So the battery has a capacity of around 80 kilowatt hours, and the motor has a power output of 125 kilowatts.
Ah oui, des constructeurs assez connus entre Safran, un mix aussi avec Garmin, etc. Garmin as well, but a well-known mm-hmm. avionic provider.
Yeah, definitely. So the aircraft will be equipped with a full G1000 NXI mm-hmm. suite, which is already standard on our standard as an option on the DA-40NG.
Okay.
But one thing that's interesting to notice is that the EDA-40, it's not going to be a replacement of the combustion engine aircraft. Instead, it's going to be an add-on to the flight training fleet that our customers mm-hmm. use as an addition. So the idea is that pilots that are in training start off on the electric version, complete the first, say, 15 hours of flight time on the electric, because those are flights which are in the vicinity of the airfield, traffic pattern training, and then once they need to cover longer distances, they will transition to the combustion engine variant. And that means that we want to keep the interface of a pilot, so the way the aircraft is controlled, mm-hmm. the way we visualize all the engine instruments, it's going to be almost identical to the mm-hmm. NG, and making the transition very easy between the two.
Speaking about training, do Diamond Aircraft provide some training program in order to fly the EDA-40?
So Diamond Aircraft is not responsible for the flight training aspects.
Mm-hmm.
We just provide the means to do so the aircraft. So that's typically the combination of a ground-based simulator, mm-hmm. the DA-40, as a single engine and the DA42 mm-hmm. as a twin engine. We are in cooperation with one of our customers, Lufthansa, mm-hmm. Lufthansa Aviation Training, and we've just completed a round of flight testing together with them in Switzerland last week, where we really demonstrated the capability of this aircraft in a pilot training environment. So over the course of 2 days, we've done several flights where we demonstrated the ability to practice traffic patterns. We've demonstrated mm-hmm. the endurance of the aircraft and how suitable it actually is to use as mm-hmm. a pilot training means.
Speaking about numbers now, yeah. Do you target the certification of the CS23 certification yes. of the EDR40?
So that's a good question to ask. So we're right now in the middle of the whole certification process. We're currently doing the flights on this aircraft, and we are building up a second conforming aircraft to really make some progress in the, mm-hmm. in the certification testing. As it's looking right now, we would complete the certification on this aircraft by the mid of 2025.
Okay, both for EASA and FAA?
So we're doing a concurrent validation, okay. Concurrent certification with the American authorities as well. Mm-hmm. However, as it looks right now, initially it will be with EASA certification, with the FAA to follow afterwards.
Okay. Let's speak now about some performances aspects.
Yeah.
For example, what's the maximum takeoff weight?
So I already hinted earlier that we want to keep the differences between the DA40 NG mm-hmm. and the EDA40 as small as possible. Mm-hmm. That is due to two reasons. First of all, we want to provide this easy transition between the electric variant and the combustion engine variant. But secondly, it makes our life a lot easier in terms of certification, because we're not doing a complete new certification of the aircraft, but we're doing an STC where we only certify the electric power plant. Okay. So we keep the performances as similar as possible between the two. That means we don't change the envelope, so the takeoff mass will remain the same, which is 1,310 kilograms. The power rating will remain the same of 125 mm-hmm. kilowatts. So the pilots can expect similar performance. So
okay.
climb rate, speed. However, we did tweak the motor a bit. First test that we saw, we were actually getting a bit better performance compared to the combustion engine, mm-hmm. just because the electric motor actually provides a bit more torque.
And now what's the autonomy of the plane and the range?
Yeah, so range is not that interesting for this aircraft, as we use for flight training, which is all in the vicinity. Mm-hmm. So what really counts is the endurance. So we're confident that we can provide an aircraft that has a useful endurance of over an hour. In fact, we've already completed several flight tests where we went above the hour set point, and we're slowly expanding that envelope.
I've heard about 74 minutes.
Yeah, but that's the total endurance. Okay. We feel comfortable right now, but in fact, looking at the performance of the system, it could also be more than that.
Yes, Martin, thank you once again for your warm welcome,
yep.
and what the next steps during the certification process of the EDF-40.
Yeah, so the next steps of the certification is basically making sure that the subcomponents get their certification done. Mm-hmm. So both partners are quite well advanced with the certification. Mm-hmm. Safran expecting to get their type certificate of a motor by the mid of this year. And with EP Systems, the battery supplier, getting a TSO approval for the battery system in the months after. So once these two puzzle pieces are in place, it's only up to us to finish the on-aircraft certification, mm-hmm. so the integration of it, which I already said, is likely to follow by the mid of 2025.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Martin, once again for your warm welcome, and good luck in the certification process.
Yeah, thanks. It's a very exciting project for all of us. We're really showing the novelty of the technology, and I'm very excited to see where it heads in the coming years. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks again.
Bye.